Hello, my name is Ryan Spilkin, and today we're here to talk about hierarchy for Jira with Thanos Batagianis. Thanos, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for the invitation, Ryan.
Always a pleasure to speak to you. Coming to us today from Athens, Greece. It's already hot, huh?
Yeah, well, it could be hotter, but yeah, it's really warm.
Excellent. Well, Thanos, tell us what your role is and what you work on day to day.
So, as you said, I'm Thanos Batagianis, and I'm a software engineer working for cloud applications and services. I'm part of the team that we are taking care of the underlying infrastructure for our company's apps.
Nice. So you're handling all of our internal software. You're handling some of our like the back end of the software that the customers are using. Is that a fair statement?
Exactly. Yes.
Ah, just a couple of applications under your purview. All right. So you being an internal resource to the Adaptavist group, you got your eyes on hierarchy for Jira relatively early. We always like to sip our own champagne and try our products internally. What got you to look at hierarchy for Jira and go, yeah, I think we need to try all that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, it's not that funny story. Six months ago, I think, or more, the project manager, our product owner, project manager, decided to leave the team. So then we sit down, the developers and the engineers of the team, and we try to kind of organize our work, what we would have to do for the next 6 months or a year, right? And obviously, you know, the first thing is we try to organize our work and our stories in the proper Jira way with the correct issue types and, you know, everything, epics and other issue types. And once this was done, the biggest problem that we had, and keep in mind, we are software engineers, right? We didn't know how to visualize at a glance and like really with a really simple tool app or whatever our work, because Jira obviously offers some functionality, you know, with JQLs and everything, but it was too complex for my simple mind, and I just really wanted one view so I can see where we are, what our initiatives, where our initiatives are, you know, the progress and everything, and then, you know, where we're going, what is in progress, what is done, things like that. And then we came across this the app, which is called Hierarchy for Jira. It used to be called Agile Docs, I remember correct. And from, you know, descriptions and everything, I said, we can give it a go. The guys offered it for us free as well. So yeah, that was a big plus. And the moment we, install the app, and the first thing you see is what personally I was looking for, and is the simplicity. And probably I'm gonna mention that word quite often, because this is huge. This is huge for me. Simple way, simple to use, simple to, you know, understand what it's doing and get the result, get the view that I wanted to see.
Thanos, before you implemented Hierarchy for Jira, while you were still trying to figure out, while the team was working together to hash out how they were going to track their work, what were those discussions like? How were people trying to define the levels? Like, how were you trying to work around the problem?
Well, there were a lot of F words, because what we were trying to do was we were trying to use the JQL, the Jira JQL, the native thing, but honestly, it was a kind of was first of all was quite complicated, you know, to go through the JQL and, you know, just put the keywords that you want in order to get the, sorry, put the keywords that you need in order to get the view that you want, right? So, after we finished, obviously, they work with structuring our tickets or issues in a proper way. That was the biggest challenge, and this what we this was that we were trying to solve, like the view. We don't want to spend hours looking at, you know, epics and initiatives and everything. We just want really quickly to see where we are.
All right, so you install Hierarchy for Jira, you turn it on, you're impressed with the simplicity. Tell us about those first few moves. How do you start to organize your issues at that point?
Actually, I can demonstrate that for you if that's okay with you.
Absolutely, let's see it.
Cool. So I'm gonna share my screen now. Cool. So this is actually the view Hierarchy for Jira gives to us, right? And as a team, we decided, because a bit of background, our team is working in two different platforms. One we call it Connect platform, and the other one Future platform. And on top of that, there are things that are common in those two platforms, like, you know, security and things like that, which we assign them to this core category. So we said, okay, we're gonna organize our works on the highest level into those focus areas, we call them. And then after, under each focus area, you can see the initiatives or the epics or the issues that we work at. So the moment you install, the moment we install the hierarchy for Jira, then if you, yeah, you select the filter of our project, Cloud Foundation is our team, the name of our team, and then you just get that view, which is actually what I really had in mind.
This is essentially the first thing you see.
Exactly.
Do you have to designate the issues on the left as the top level issue?
No, because the way Hierarchy for Jira works is you have like a parent issue, and then underneath you can declare children, and then Hierarchy for Jira understands that, you know, this is the parent, so it goes on top of the hierarchy. So this is what you see first. For us, the core is the parent of the parents. You know, actually, the core issue doesn't have any parents, so it comes first on hierarchy. And then if I expand it, sorry, you can see this issue type of initiative, which has a core as a parent and then has other children, and, you know, goes like that.
Wow. That is really simple and straightforward.
Exactly. Yes, exactly. And you know, you can expand everything and you can see the progress of it, you know, just scrolling. And I really like that tree view. I'm like a big fan of the tree view.
Same. Okay, Thanos, this looks pretty cool. Can you show me some of the other features, some of the other things that you really enjoy about Hierarchy for Jira?
Yes. One of the really nice things, I believe this is like a new addition, is that you can easily create quick filters. So for example, you can see only in that tree view the tickets that are in progress or the tickets that are unsigned to yourself, and you can select it. And again, you know, you have again what you're looking for in this nice tree kind of view. And again, you can select which, because by default, as we said, the parent is on top, but again, a hierarchy for Jira gives you this functionality to select what do you want to be on the top of that tree, which is quite, you know, is quite useful. For example, if you want to track your epics or stories or the RFCs that we write before we implement a feature resolution, and we can see what is in progress, what is done, and what is next, that, you know, next on our backlog to work on.
Nice, really neat. Are there any other features that stand out to you as super useful?
Yes, well, it's the fact that you can
add awesome.
Columns. yes, indeed. So you can select anything, even custom fields or, you know, the Jira fields or, you know, time tracking options, all the fields that you can have in a ticket. You can see that in your view, the preview. Yeah.
That's a good idea. Good idea and easy to use. Wow. So this really, yes. It makes visibility just so simple.
Exactly. Right? Exactly. This is the point.
Yeah. Wow. All right. So, I mean, I can immediately see how this is going to be useful for teams that are not software. Like any team using Jira could theoretically use this to organize their work just in a neat, orderly pile, for lack of a better word. But what do you think some other uses for hierarchy for Jira might be?
As you said, I really believe the audience, let's say, the target group, let's say, is like people that are not, let's say, like, you know, project managers who are working with tools, like complicated tools, but this is like this is their job. They, you know, they know how to handle these complex tools. If you want something simple, hierarchy for Jira definitely deserves a go. Plus, I have to mention, the guys offer like tremendous support. Whenever you have a question or a bug, which I haven't found a lot, to be honest, their support channel is, people in their support channel is always there to address your questions or fix any problems you may find.
Very nice. All right. So in order to get started with hierarchy for Jira, follow the link that we've included here in this video or search for it on the Atlassian Marketplace. Thanos Batagiannis, thanks again for talking hierarchy for Jira with me today.
Thanks a lot, Brian. Always a pleasure.